everything had a purpose in planning this event. Everything, all the plants aligned just right, the sunset just right, everything happened as if it was meant to be.
Great, great, great. All right, green flag.
The green flag is down!
NL Valley's sick, dude. They freaking finally are stepping up and letting the course get all rutted up and hammered. When it's gnarly and not the track isn't consistent, it makes racing really good.
It has the smooth, hard pack, tight corners, and then you come around and it's super high speed and goes into like sand and ruts and whoops and holes. I mean, it's awesome. I think it's one of the best tracks.
I'm excited. I think there's going to be some exciting racing here in Antelope Valley. Last round of the TORC series. We're at the Rick Jeffman Cup race, and Rick was a monster athlete, and you know he was a friend of ours, and you know we're here to support.
Hey, you know Rick and Jeff were awesome in the world of short course. I mean, Rick came through the ranks of Pro Light. He skipped Pro 2, went right to Pro 4. And he changed Pro 4. The way Pro 4 is where it is right now is because of Rick Huseman.
He had his own style. I mean, no one did it like him.
You do have the fastest, a new track record. What does that mean to you?
That means we got a new record to break.
It was crazy because we had just wrapped up the championship in Texas.
And, you know, it just kind of took the wind out of everyone's sails knowing that something that tragic had happened on such a happy day.
I mean, the whole racing industry, especially off-road, just melted.
When his accident happened, it was devastating.
Someone posted, "Rest in peace, Rick Huseman," and my mom read it. She's like, "That can't be right." So then it completely changed the mood of what was going on.
It was really tough on me and my family. They're in the same stage of life that we are. They're trying to make racing work. They have young kids, and to see that all torn apart is just heartbreaking.
Even to this day, it's hard to talk about it. And I guess it's cool just to be out here, know that Rick's looking down on us, and know that we're racing for him.
You know, this weekend is really about the honoring the memory of Jeff and Rick Huseman. We put together a couple great cup events, the Traxxas Cup presented in memory of Jeff Huseman, and then of course the Rick Huseman Cup, which is presented by Peak. And doing that in the memory of Rick and Jeff, we put a good stamp on it this weekend.
We're We're here for the Huseman Memorial Golf Tournament. Out here having some fun, remembering Rick and Jeff. So we're out here with everybody, just golfing, kind of messing around before the weekend. It's all for Rick and Jeff.
Oh, Huseman was a teammate to me, and you know, he was one of those guys that always did everything different. I kind of want to be the same way, and to look at somebody that doesn't like to do anything like anyone else, you know, that's somebody to look up to be a champion. That's what he was, so it's good.
Remember his legacy, and you know, this whole weekend's for him.
Hey, how we doing? How about this day out here for Rick, huh?
Yeah.
This is pretty awesome. We got a great course. We got great weather.
Gonna ruin some balls, mess up some carts, and probably cost us some golf clubs.
All right.
We had a ton of fun. We had a good group. And with good people, man, you get exciting times. And we saw a lot of skid plates and roofs falling off and, you know, broken golf clubs. And we also saw some good golfers because we can all play. So it was fun. We had a good time. And, man, I can't wait to do that again.
Longest drive of the day, Casey Curry.
Woo!
Yeah, but it's back here. It's up here. Come on.
That's a good shot.
I thought I knew Rick pretty well until Rick passed. And then I got to know him a whole lot better in his passing. The guy's really such a quality person. His family's such a quality people. It's amazing how many friends he had and how deep those people were and how they affected so many people's lives. You know, we still feel the presence of Rick. He's definitely reached out and touched our lives. And, you know what? There's a lot of guys out here racing really hard this weekend, and there's nobody that's going to forget about Rick Huseman. He set the bar in off-road Pro 4. There's no question.
It's something we can all set our sights on, how to walk this life. Yeah. Rick Huseman, rest in peace, brother. We'll see you.
Come on, drive it in, drive it in.
Young driver, 16 years old, going after defending class champion Curry.
Momentum, momentum, you got him clear, go.
You know, we definitely had speed for the leader. Casey just was more aggressive, and then anytime I got next to him, he just pinched me off.
Gotta make it happen right here.
You can hear right now CJ Greaves on the move.
Push him out. Just push him out.
Taking the win in the last points race of 2011 will be RJ Anderson.
Clear.
Second, Casey Curry, and third will be CJ Greaves.
Good effort, bud. Good job.
I was fucked up a little bit, but oh!
CJ. No.
Dude, he just fucking ran me.
That's racing. That was a clean race.
He was clear. He was already clear.
He wasn't.
Clear. He was right next to me.
But it's all right. It's all right. I just won't lift next time.
Riding that Pro Light Cup race that they added for at the end of Sunday is going to be a lot more pressure.
It's the biggest race I've been involved in.
Basically, for tomorrow, I mean, our game plan is to win.
Somebody's probably going to be in victory lane, happy as they could be. And somebody's going to be down here pissed off and yelling. And that's just the way the race is.
Cup race is game on. It's after the end. Whatever happens, happens. I guess we're leaving it all on the track.
The inaugural Traxxas Pro Light Cup race. $15,000 to the winner. Green flag is out.
My boy. I was running clean up front, everything was good, and there was some square edge building up out there, and I might have just clipped it and blew out the sidewall.
Yeah.
Good job, buddy. Good job, buddy. Thanks. Great race, you guys.
you know, running this race for Rick and Jeff. I'm glad that TORC found a way to do it, and here on the West Coast.
And this is our celebration with you guys, celebrating the lives of Rick and Jeff Huseman.
Let's run it for Jeff, guys!
This is a special weekend. We're really excited. You guys can see the reason we're here is because a few drivers put a bug on my ear that this is a good idea. One, we need a tribute to Rick. Two, this is a great venue. It all came together, and we can thank a couple people. Brian Emmerich, he'll be here tomorrow from Pete, who put the cash up behind it to make this all work. This was Run It for Rick weekend, and now it's time, you know, run it like Rick. You know, put the hammer down, run like Rick would, and then they're all going to go for it. I know that, you know, yesterday was a very emotional day for a few people. You know, I talked to Michelle a couple times over the weekend, and Thursday was a golf outing. We had a lot of fun, and Michelle looked at me and said, you know, this was our, this would have been our anniversary today.
Scott Rain and Jen, they found Jeffrey's Pro Light, and they brought it here to events, and they promoted the race, and we love you guys so much.
Thank you.
My dad and Rick were really good friends. My mom and Michelle are good friends. I mean, we go snowboarding during the winter and stuff, and Rick would always come out to Glen Helen when we were out there and hang out. And I mean, he was almost just like a regular guy to me that I saw every day.
You know, running this race for Rick and Jeff, I'm glad that TORC found a way to do it. And here on the West Coast, it's a great deal. Me and Rick were really close. Jeff was a good friend of mine.
I raced with Rick and Jeff, and I know the brothers Danny. I mean, they're great people. Jeff came in, and Jeff was a great guy, great driver too. I mean, he came out hot.
I really like the way Jeff ran his program. Like, he was never like as big a name as Rick was, but Jeff was so cool that he just had a Pro Light. He worked on it by himself, like under an easy up behind Rick's semi.
Jeff Huseman was a bright star in this whole off-road world, and if, you know, he was doing it with funding that was, I mean, they were building everything themselves, almost even their own motors and everything. And so Jeff in the Pro Light class accomplished what he accomplished with next to nothing. That was pretty impressive. So Rick and Jeff, we miss them both. And like I said, I miss the family in the sport because they were just a class act.
He never got quite where Rick was, but he worked his tail off and he did almost everything on his truck himself. And that's what made him the champion that he was. Even though he never earned the championship, he worked harder than anybody.
This whole weekend's for them, and that's what we're out here to celebrate.
And it has been a really, really emotional weekend. Even the drivers meeting today, we started talking about how to do things and how to run it for Rick. I could just see the mood of the driver meeting going pretty heavy-hearted at that point, realizing what was going on here today.
You know, when he came to the track, he was a family guy. You know, he always had his family around him. His brothers worked for him. He was quiet, and he just got the job done. And the crazy thing is he had so much more in the bag. The way they talked, they were doing so much over that season to make things so much gnarlier for next year, and to not ever get to see that come to life is kind of a bummer. And you know, he was an innovator for sure, and that's what we want to be in the sport. So to have somebody to look up to, you know, he was definitely one of the guys.
This year has been the hardest, worst year of my life, but with all the support, it's made it a little bit easier, you know. And Rick and Jeff were definitely saved because, you know, they were saved at a really young age, so we know for sure that they're with the Lord.
Born again, yes.
So our faith is what's gotten us through this last year, knowing that they're in heaven and that we're going
to be again. Any special pre-race rituals for this final race?
No, just pray that it all works out good, you know, and be there at the end. That's what we're hoping for.
A couple special things to think about and help us out with. We'd like at least 20 trucks to participate in a truck parade. We'll park right downtown in the main street of Lancaster.
This is our celebration with you guys, celebrating the lives of Rick and Jeff Huseman. They were killed in a plane crash almost 1 year to the date of this weekend. That truck right there is a former class champion of Pro 4. That is Rick Huseman's truck right there. His younger brother, Jeff Huseman, his truck was out here somewhere as well. Tomorrow, on the Lancaster, at the Antelope Valley Fairgrounds, you are all invited to come out and celebrate the lives of these two drivers. For the $15,000 Traxxas Jeff Huseman Memorial Cup Race in the Pro Light Division. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks for coming out. Come on up. Let's meet the drivers, get some pictures, autographs. And some of the best off-road drivers in the world. They're right here near me right now. Thanks for coming out, Mike.
Eddie. I'm going to throw you. Don't worry.
Can you drive one of these? Don't take my ride, okay?
You like that?
Everything had a purpose in planning this event. Everything, all the planets aligned just right, the sunset just right. Everything happened as if it was meant to be, as if Jeff and Rick Huseman are watching down on us and helping us make this thing, you know, come out. It's almost 2 weeks to the one-year anniversary of their plane crash where they were killed. This is also the site of Rick Huseman's first ever Pro 4 career win. This also was the site of Jeff Huseman's first pole qualifying run in Pro Light. They're watching us. They're with us. I mean, we miss these guys. We think about them all the time. Every race that we go to.
Yeah, you know, Rick was a monster driver, and he drove like it. And the cup race, we know, I mean, the whole time I'm out there when I take off, I know this is for Rick. I'm laying everything on the line. It's the last race. I'm going to do it the way Rick would do it.
The race is going to be very, very exciting because it's a huge purse. So that should be.
It's turning out to be such an awesome event. It's, we're really having a good time, and it's really heartwarming to see how much they were loved.
Get ready for the Traxxas Jeff Huseman Pro Light Memorial Cup. You see 15 of the best Pro Light drivers gathering around Noah Fouch's Pro Light, which happened to be Jeff Huseman's Pro Light of just a few years ago. Jim, this is the first time that a lot of these drivers had a chance to even see this truck, and it is really a tough one for a lot of these guys.
There's no doubt about that. And how fitting is it that right here in Antelope Valley is where Jeff earned his very first pole award, as we rise right now for a moment of silence in the remembrance of Jeff Huseman.
We miss him a lot, and I'd much rather be racing against him than racing in memory of him.
The Traxxas Pro Light Cup in memory of Jeff Huseman is at the line. $15,000 to the winner.
Cup race no holds barred. So much different than a points race. We just clinched the championship. Brad Lovell earning that first championship in an awesome race season, but it's totally different right here. All the money's on the line, plus it means a little more this weekend.
There was so much effort for the crews to get their trucks ready after the championship round to get ready for the Cup, and now for the first time all year long, they probably get to sit in the stands and actually watch their driver race for the first time.
Today, it is on. There is no racing tomorrow. This is all the money on the line, plus different than a points race, there's no mandatory caution halfway through. It's on start to finish.
And the other thing to keep in mind, I don't want to say it out loud, but the black flag in a race like this is virtually kind of taken away and kind of put off to the side. It's run what you brung. It's on the line. It's all about the efforts. And, okay, the black flag's no longer in use. How far across that line, how aggressive can I be to get to the front?
Well, the drivers, they know what it's like, and they're going to let it all rip here in just a second. Keegan Kincaid out there in the number 7 Traxxas truck. He's going to lead him to the line, sitting on the pole position today.
And don't forget about that $15,000 and added incentive. Okay, the last chance for payback for any of the drivers against their other competitors, but there's also that $15,000. Speaks real loud at a moment like now.
Well, that $15,000, I don't know how far it could go. That might just be in repairs of damage, depending on what happens in this race. We see C.J. Greaves right there, last year's winner of the Traxxas Pro Light Cup.
And the thing is, if I'm on the front row, I got to be a little bit nervous right now because you got Team Monster Energy starting 3rd, 4th, and 5th all together. They're on the podium. All three guys are on the podium earlier this weekend. So that's got to be a kind of an ominous feeling. Those three guys are behind me right now.
Andrew Cadell, the 2011 champion, up there with the number 1 plate on the front row next to Keegan Kincaid. And what a year for Keegan Kincaid as they come around and take the green flag, and we are underway.
How about that start by Keegan? Went way around the outside. It looked like he was going to be getting pulled the hole shot by Andrew Cadell, but Keegan Kincaid does it going to turn number 1.
Yeah, I kind of wonder if Andrew thought maybe he jumped a little and went back. I don't know, but he's sitting there right now as he goes wide.
Huge push into turn number 1. Casey Curry comes around on the inside. But how about again, Keegan Kincaid? Already 8-9 truck length lead.
Now Kincaid looking to the outside. He's going to look inside.
Come on, get up there by Curry. Don't let him get over.
Take a look on board at Casey Curry right there out the number 2 machine. Trying to get ahead of Andrew Cadell, and does for just a second. Casey holds the position, but here comes Andrew to the inside.
Take deep breath. Clear by 4 behind you. Look ahead. Keep pushing. Clear by 4.
Now, this isn't an unusual position for Keegan Kincaid. He's done so well all year long, landed a podium a few times. And, you know, I'm still amazed that a guy with a 6'5" frame can fit inside a Pro Light. Keegan's a big guy.
Right now, Casey Curry in the number 2 monster truck is definitely reeling him in as a little bit of gap goes back to the 3rd place truck of Andrew Cadell.
Right front flat.
And it looks like a right front flat on C.J. Greaves. Big problems already for the young driver.
We're going to get a tire anyway because you never know what's going to happen.
It's all different here. You cannot pit and expect to get your position back at the halfway mandatory caution because that does not exist out here today. So it's tough. Roll the dice. Whether you roll on that flat, it's real early in the race.
Keegan Kincaid right now in that Traxxas number 7 having a heck of a run. He's had one whale of a 2012 season, and I'm still amazed. A kid as big as him, 6'4" tall, can even fit inside a Pro Light. And Luke Johnson goes over. One of our class favorites, Luke Johnson, right now on his lid.
You okay, buddy?
Not sure whether Luke has communication with his spotter now, but he's lowering the safety net, kind of a universal sign that he is okay.
And it looks like Nick Baumgartner just wails into turn 1.
Full course yellow.
Get into pit.
Moves up one spot, but we got 2 trucks. Man, one day ago it was Monster Energy on the podium, 1, 2, and 3, and right now we got 2 guys from Monster Energy in the pits.
And the number 14 getting attended to, trying to get Luke Johnson.
And Jared Brooks goes off the track.
TORC safety crews on the scene. Some of the best in the business.
And it looks like we're going full course yellow, which will
basically kind of take away any advantage that anybody had in the track. We'll regroup everybody bumper to bumper once again, as we've got trucks all over the track right now, which is an indication of these guys are hanging out big time for the last race of the year.
You know, and we talked about you couldn't bank on a full course caution because there's not a mandatory yellow, but in the event of a bad crash, you still have that.
All right, you're getting a second chance here. Let's take advantage of it.
And you heard C.J. Greaves, his father, Johnny Greaves, spotter, talking to him about just that. Now he's got some second life.
And you just saw R.J. Anderson right there, right rear flat tire. So he's trying to hightail it to the hot pitch right now. Get that truck, that right rear change, and back out on the lead lap as Luke Johnson gets back on all fours. We'll see if he's got any kind of mechanical issues. Maybe he can get back underway.
Still yellow. We've got time. Still yellow. Just be patient with them. Then leave it off. See if it'll fire.
And Luke gets the truck fired up. You see that big puff of white smoke from being upside down. The oil settles at the top of the engine. You don't want to rev it up just yet until you make sure everything's fine. But maybe some second life for Luke as well. Now, what's the ruling on that? Is he able to be on the tail end of the lead lap?
If he can get out there before the lead truck goes by, yes, he's on the lead lap, but he'll obviously be in the back of the pack.
Spinning out, and RJ's got suspension trouble, and he's in the pit right now. 10 foot.
That's Roger Cadell right now talking to his son Andrew out on the track. Still looking very strong. Andrew's still in the top five, as it looks like now Luke Johnson's back underway. We still don't know if there's any vehicle damage to see if he's going to be hampered at all, but he's at least back out underway.
Yeah, correction, you're in fifth. My bad. Come all the way to the end of the K-rail and take a left. Truck looks good. Feel it out. Catch up to the field. They're just now in the hairpin. Feel good or got something wrong?
Luke Johnson is back out on the track.
Good job this year, Luke. Good job.
As they're lined up behind the Mopar Ram Runner, single file will be the restart.
Poor Traxxas boys put in a lot of work to go one lap.
The Traxxas entry of Keegan Kincaid still has the lead. And Casey Curry, right now the lone Monster Energy truck on the track running in second.
We'll be going green this time.
Will RJ Anderson be able to get back out there? He was stuck in that pit for a long time.
There's Luke Johnson pulling off the track, now pulling out of the hot pits, and it looks like completely out of the facility, headed back to the pits.
Couldn't see it, but you talked about it. There must be problems with that truck. It's just not worth continuing. Not the way he'd like to end 2012.
Under full course yellow, getting ready to retake the green flag in the Traxxas Pro Light Cup in memory of Jeff Huseman. And now the guys are all bumper to bumper in a single file line.
Crazy things going on. Baumgartner off the side of the track. Luke Johnson upside down. RJ Anderson and CJ Greaves both in the pits with flat tires. Some of these guys, where they would have been out of the race, now have new life thanks to that yellow flag.
Clear by one. You're clear by one.
And once again, Keegan Kincaid pulls the whole shot heading to turn number one, but Casey Curry's right in tow.
Coming off that last points win of the year just a little while ago, Casey's looking at a great weekend and looking to hopefully add $15,000 to it as well.
And don't forget about Andrew Cadell. He's a 2011 Pro Light champion. Hasn't had the greatest of weekends of here.
Not at all. Definitely in the hunt, coming down to the final race. Got taken out, pretty much cost him the championship.
And it looks like we got contact right now between the boys from Colorado, who's Sean Morris.
Go, RJ's
and Brad
going around the outside.
Our new champion.
Yeah. Casey Curry still running in second, trying to find a way to reel Keegan Kincaid back in. Right now, it looks like our top five trucks are about equal gap, about 3-4 truck lengths between all of them.
Yeah, where Casey was all over the back of the leader going into the yellow flag, Keegan's stretched it out just a little bit.
Andrew, on these rollers, go all the way to the outside on the first two, on the right side. It'll be on the right side.
How about Jared Brooks winning the top five in front of our new class champion, Brad Lovell?
By two. Let's go. Chase down that 7-7.
Jared, a young kid coming up from the kart ranks, now racing this Pro Light category, doing very well.
All right, get back on him. You're doing it. You're catching him down. He's going to make a mistake.
Brad Lovell goes inside of Brooks, takes a look. Nothing there. It looked like Brad had checked up just a little bit on that right-hand corner, still trying to find a way around that young man, Jared Brooks.
Well, at this point, is making that truck very wide. Top four still pretty evenly capped. Brad Lovell closing in on Brooks just a little bit.
Clear by four over RJ. Clear by four or five.
Keegan Kincaid would love to end the 2012 season with $15,000. I can just imagine what's going through his dad's head right now. Jeff Kincaid.
Jeff Kincaid, one of the elite racers in the Pro 2 category, and has several cup wins to his repertoire over the years. Spotting for his son, Keegan.
And you can see right there one of the big ruts, that right-hand turn starting to form. Again, I emphasize the fact it's playing into Casey Curry's hands. I'm just wondering when Casey's going to try to make his move.
You got him. Dig, dig, go, go.
Yeah, what's in his head? Is he just trying to pace it for now, let the race come? Obviously, a little over half of the race yet to go.
You can miss these first two bumps all the way to the right. And after you're by them, then you can cut down. If you do that, I believe it will be faster.
How about K2, Kenny Kincaid, spotting right now, letting his driver know. You know, we've got to keep in mind that Kenny's also a former driver, so he knows where the fast places are on the track. He's got a vantage point from the stands where the drivers may not on the track, so he's seeing who's got the faster lines and the best way to get around this track.
Trying to get it into his driver, Andrew Cadell's head, that there might be faster lines that he can't see down on the track.
Casey Curry diving into that final turn, made up about three truck lengths right there in that one spot.
As I talked about earlier, does he make his move now? I mean, position is everything out there on a racetrack, or kind of let it come to you. So far, Kincaid out there in the lead, a flawless race.
Wow, Casey Curry is right in the back bumper on that turn number one. He is definitely on the charge, trying to make a move. Now, one thing I noticed right away, Keegan Kincaid been running up front this entire race. His truck looks like it just started the race. Brand new, everything perfectly in position. All the fenders are intact. Casey Curry, his truck right now, all tore apart. Not one rear fender on that thing.
Track looks to be in pretty good shape as far as the traction out there. The holes are starting to form and get deeper as you see him cutting some of these ruts and popping up onto two wheels, more so as the race goes on.
Casey cannot just reel in our leader and try to make a pass. We've said it all season long. In off-road racing, it's much like NASCAR. They have to get a run at their lead car to try to make a pass. And that looks like what Casey Curry's probably going to have to try to do right here.
Drive back to your inside, but you got a car in there.
Also depends on where his fast line is. You can't take the same line. You have to find your way around, either the outside or the inside.
I'm still waiting for Andrew Cadell to try to work his way up front. He's not really, you know, he's had a rough weekend, but in this race in particular, he's not looking all that strong just yet.
I almost expected him to come out here with more vengeance and overdriving the car, if anything.
Yeah, Andrew's the kind of guy where he initially has a chip on his shoulder, but I think after a while, his dad kind of calms down a little bit, and that may be what's happening right now. He's a little bit on the calm side, trying to run a race, but I still don't see the aggressiveness I've seen him in the past.
And quite a gap is now between the number two truck of Casey Curry and Andrew Cadell.
Seven to go. Clear by 15.
It looks like our top three trucks have pulled away from the entire field. As the number seven Traxxas entry of Keegan Kincaid still maintains the lead, but I'm still waiting for Casey Curry and Andrew Cadell to try to reel in our leader.
Yeah, you got to go now. You can't bank on the fact that there may be another caution out there, because there may not.
That was fast to that section.
Keegan Kincaid running up on that high line, that left rear tire riding on that berm, trying to find that traction. Casey Curry just about one lane lower in that turn, trying to make up a little bit of ground. Right now, does not look like it's working for him.
Looking for alternative lines to, like you mentioned before, reel him in, and then once you get there, it's yet another thing to get around him. So just feeling it out here with several laps to go, finding out how he's going to make his move when he doesn't.
Stop, he can't see.
I'm telling you, just a few laps remaining. Keegan Kincaid has to run a perfect race, not one mistake. Because right now, Casey Curry is that close. He may be two, three truck lengths behind, but he is that close.
And oh, look at this, the hood of Sean Morris up over the windshield, taking away all visibility.
Right there is the perfect description of the 2012 season for Sean Morris. He has shown flashes of brilliance, been very fast at times, but something crazy always happens to hinder his day.
We saw a couple podiums out of him throughout the year. He was looking for a big win and was pretty confident coming into today, too, but that's a big problem.
Five to go.
Sean Morris still looking really fast. And oh, man, look out! Wanted to get out of the way, tried to pull off to the left side of the course, and looked like he almost took out R.J. Anderson. And now Sean Morris pulls off the track into the hot pits.
The crew is sitting there waiting, collectively going to try to rip the hood off, get the 27 back out there to join the fight for the Traxxas Pro Light Cup.
The track here at Lancaster, California is going away with just a few laps remaining in the Traxxas Pro Light Cup in memory of Jeff Huseman.
And for a lot of these guys, these desert drier conditions on this track, different than what they've been used to all year long.
And you can see the rust forming, especially in that final turn. Has to be about 2-3 feet deep in the race line. More importantly, the guys have to figure out if they want to go on the high side around it or duck down to the inside.
Four laps to go, time running out for Casey Curry and the rest of the field. Keegan Kincaid continues to lead in that number 7 Traxxas truck.
Six, that's fifth in front of you.
Casey Curry came into the TORC series earlier this year at the Crandon International Off-Road Raceway, swept the weekend, trying right now to end the season with a $15,000 check, but time is running out.
What a great season he's had here in the TORC series, but right now he's running second fiddle to the man in the number 7, Keegan Kincaid, still continuing to dominate this race.
This is a point in the race where it's fun for me to watch the lines of our top trucks, especially at this point when they're running different lines. Casey Curry's watching. He's been watching Keegan the entire race, where he's going, what's been fast for him, and Casey Curry has to run opposite lines that Keegan Kincaid is right now.
Inside.
Casey Curry in the number 2 Monster Energy truck starting to close the gap. Scott, what does Keegan Kincaid have to do to remain calm and hold off the charge of Casey Curry? Because you know he's going to make a move.
Well, it's twofold. It's really simple. You just got to run a flawless race, or it's complex in that you still have to maintain aggressiveness. You still have to be fast, but also you got to run a perfect line. You got to keep that truck behind you of Casey Curry. You know, there's a fast line and there's the blocking line, trying to stay in the front. And right now you got to find that happy medium. And it looks like Casey Curry is starting to push the limit on what Keegan Kincaid can handle.
A lot of times in off-road racing, the low line is where you want to be. The guy's going to get around you, make him go around you faster and make the pass on the outside.
And it looks like that's exactly where Casey Curry was going, on the outside, but at the last minute ducked to the inside, still not able to get around.
Keegan Kincaid, his first year in the Pro Light class. Scott, does he have the experience to hold off a veteran like Casey Curry? He left the inside line open, and it shows Casey was able to close the gap just now.
And it looks like, oh, they make contact. Keegan over-rotates just a little bit in the corner, just enough for Casey Curry to get inside. And Casey Curry now, like we've said all year long, smells blood in the water. He's a shark on the hunt. But to answer your question, Jim, yes, he has to run to the inside. He has to keep it tight and low. And right now he's listening to his dad doing just that as he goes outside one more time. Not only on the outside, but up on two wheels. And now Casey Curry's right behind as the white flag is waving. Keegan Kincaid has just one lap remaining. And look, he's getting sideways back and forth down the straightaway to turn one. And that is scrubbing off speed. Casey Curry trying to find a line. Kincaid up against the wall on the inside, gets up on two wheels. Keegan Kincaid now goes way to the outside, saves it, but we got a brand new leader. Casey Curry was waiting for that one mistake and now has the lead.
The one time Kincaid goes low to block Casey Curry, he catches a run and goes up on two wheels. Maybe that's why he was holding off.
With less than a half lap remaining, Casey Curry could do the same thing, could make the mistake, so Keegan Kincaid himself has to stay just as aggressive.
Keegan's definitely still in the picture and in the game, but right now it's the Monster Energy number 2 Nissan of Casey Curry out front.
through the final turn. Now into the Red Bull finish line. $15,000 richer. Casey Curry will take the win.
And Keegan Kincaid, who led almost all of this race, holds on for second place.
And crossing the line in third is the number one Mopar of Andrew Cadell.
Dude, Keegan threw it away on the last lap. Curry wins it.
But the man on top once again, the winner of the Traxxas Pro Light Cup in the memory of Jeff Huseman, is Casey Curry.
And talk about a dominant 2012 season. He hasn't run the whole year with TORC, but every round that he showed up, he's been on the podium. If he hasn't won, he's been on the podium. Not only Chicago, but Crandon, and now here at Lancaster. Kincaid up against the wall on the inside, gets up on two wheels. Keegan Kincaid now goes way to the outside, saves it, but we got a brand new leader. $15,000 richer, Casey Curry will take the win.
Congrats goes out to Casey. You know, he just pressured me a little bit, and I made that mistake back there. And oh, it's tough. Take me a while to get over this one.
Good race. I would rather see Keegan win it, but I don't know. I'm just disappointed.
It just goes to show that, you know, I can compete with these guys. You know, I'm up here, and you know, next year I'm gonna be coming for that championship. You know, so Brad Lovers, watch out.
Write that check.
Keegan was driving good. Dude. He was killing it that whole race. Dude, he never made any mistakes. And the track was getting rough. I knew if I just kept putting the pressure on, he was slowly losing a little bit. And I'm not going to lie, when he got up on two wheels right there, I took it. I wasn't going to wait. I wasn't going to slow down. I went for it. I needed that win. This team deserves it more than any team out here. We've been working our butts off this year. And I lost this race last year on the last lap, and we need to bring home that number one.
We were kind of counting on him, you know, being a younger driver to make a mistake. And, boy, he really made us, you know, work for it today.
You know, to be up here on the box again, you know, I got to congratulate Casey and Keegan. You know, Keegan ran one heck of a race out there. I think he led every lap until the last one. So, proves that he's stepping up, and I'm just a little bumping myself right now. You know, we're here for Ricky Jeff Huseman. You know, they didn't go out there and race that race in Ricky Jeff Huseman style. You know, they would have been up there, you know, battling hard and driving as hard as they could, and I left a lot on the table out.
Ended up hooking a rut and ball go over, and Casey tucked inside and got by, and I had nothing for him after that. Got stuck on that dirt back there, so congrats goes off to Casey. You know, just to be out here racing for Jeff and Rick Huseman, and I was giving it my all. You know, that was a blast. Congrats goes out to Casey over there.
The guy who takes the $15,000 from the Traxxas Cup. Buddy, I know you were just waiting for Keegan to make those mistakes that he made there on that last lap. Were you waiting for that?
You know, I was driving the wheels off my truck. I mean, Keegan was driving a great race. It sucks that it had to happen like that. And, you know, I can't believe it. It was all 14 laps, and he was driving phenomenal. And I can't get all these fans out here now, but it's hot. And, dude, you guys just saw a great race out there. But, you know, I'm not going to lie. My parents, all my team, we've had a rough year, but we're here. You know, the Huseman family, this is for you guys. You guys did an amazing job. I mean, everything out here. This was a great event. Traxxas is amazing. $15,000. Not complaining, baby. You!
And let's hear it one more time for our Pro Light Traxxas Cup. Andrew Cadell, Keegan Kincaid, and Casey Curry on top of the box.